Laskian Corla and Minister Doyle, just to congratulate you on your appointment and wish you very well. I'm sure it's a great honour. My motion is in relation to the over-afforestation of County Leitrim, which I know you'll be aware of in your office, from other representations that have already been made to you. Traditional farming in the area is under threat. The reality is, while there are aggressive targets by the Forestry Service to increase planting throughout the country, and while that's an honourable ambition, the reality is we cannot approach the country as if it were a blank canvas. It is not. The percentage of afforestation in County Leitrim, while officially listed at 17%, anecdotally, speaking to people locally, it is certainly hugely imbalanced and, imbalanced, and maybe very significantly more than that. The fact that there are no planning regulations in relation to planning, that you need approval of the Forestry Service, is wrong. Last week, planning enforcement in Sligo informed me to take down the sign outside my office, a modest sign, which I'm not allowed to put up without planning permission. That's reasonable, and I'll take the appropriate steps. But to think that somebody can plant 17 hectares with mere approval, and in fact it seems once they have begun to plant that 17 hectares, are entitled to plant a further 17 hectares. I can give you examples in Clun in County Leitrim, where five plantations have taken almost begun in as many months. I mean, this is closing down communities. People want a right to light their view. I know there's no right to a view, but we must be cognizant of these issues and not approach the country, as I said, with a blank canvas. Now, County Leitrim, West County Cavan and parts of Sligo are being targeted effectively by wealthy speculators who can go up there, buy land for a cheaper amount, in fact pay a premium above that land, which as the net result of that is young farmers or local farmers who are looking to grow and achieve a bit of scale in the farming activity they're involved with can't compete. Young farmers can't get involved because, as I said, wealthy speculators with the benefit of premium and larger farms throughout the country who have bigger scale, shorter winters and better land are able to pay more. The premium that attaches to this afforestation covers them to the extent that they're going to make a profit, pushing local people and local communities out of the business. And remember, Minister, that part of Ireland, the northwest of the country, is a substantial part of the engine room of the suckler herd of this country, which, as you know, is where all of the weanlings come from. Some 40% of the weanlings produced in this country come from that part of the country. But if we're going to build, plant trees on every inch of land available, that local people and local farms and young people who are entitled, in my view, to begin a career in farming in that part of the country, if we're going to push them out of it by allowing this to take place, it is fundamentally wrong. We must have planning applications, we must have a need for planning for substantial afforestation, and we must approach the country in an even keel. We can't push it all into Leitrim in the northwest, West Cavan and Sligo, where effectively, and I can give you an example, and I would like you to come, Minister, I'd like you to visit Clun in County Leitrim, Drumcairn in County Leitrim, and near Black Lyne in Cavan, where I can show you three examples of a community being swallowed by afforestation, which I know in terms of the carbon footprint nationally, we need to plant more trees, and that's fine, as I said, it's admirable, but not in our part of the country. We're well covered, over covered, and it's really impeding upon those communities to proceed with the tradition of rural Ireland, to proceed with the tradition of producing quality beef through the suckler herd. And I would ask that you would make contact with my office on whatever dates are appropriate, on whatever date that you're going to be available to come to that part of the country. And I have no doubt that Deputy Eamon Scanlon, Deputy Tony McLaughlin in your own party, and Deputy Martin Kenny, who also serve that constituency, share these views and would also be happy to attend these areas with you if you were prepared to make time to come and visit. I know you have family members who are involved in forestry and perhaps know infinitely more about it than I'll ever know. But all I know is the reality on the ground, the distress that it's causing to the communities and the imbalance that it's causing to our part of the country. I know statistically it probably looks good within the Department of Agriculture and Forestry and Marine to see more trees being planted. But as I said, the negative impacts, albeit the unintended negative impacts of this, must be addressed by you. It may well be a case that the premium that attaches to these planting should be preserved for people locally, should be preserved for people that are going to be farming and from the area, rather than a speculator who has more capacity from another part of the country, who's able to go up there, make a profit, albeit pricing other guys that are local out of the market. And of course, they're looking after their carbon footprint in their own part of the country. So I would appeal to you, Minister. This is something that I know in the programme for government, that it says next year there will be a review of this issue. I know, well, anecdotally, again, it's alleged the deputy, I'm just finishing, Deputy Michael Fitzmaurice, in his own negotiations, perhaps it's one of the reasons he didn't support the government, was pushing very strongly on this issue, as I know other rural deputies have this matter very close to their heart. So I do appeal to you to take the appropriate action in this regard, and please have your office make contact about what date suits you to come down.
Thank you, Deputy. Minister.
Thank you, Cathaoirleach, and thank you, Deputy. This is my first opportunity to speak on this issue and speak on an adjournment debate. The Deputy and I know each other quite a while, and I am conscious of the issue. It's been made well aware of it, of the particular issue about afforestation in County Leitrim. Perhaps it's one of the consequences of having a policy. No matter how good it is, there's always somewhere where you're actually maybe upsetting people. Just in the first instance, and I know the Deputy acknowledged this, I believe that the important contribution that forestry makes to the Irish economy, environment and society should be acknowledged. The government has invested significantly, as have previous governments, in the development of forestry over the last number of decades. And I believe that a vibrant export-orientated forest product sector is one outcome from that investment as a contribution forestry makes to climate change mitigation. The role of the Department of Agriculture, Food and the Marine is to assist the development of the Irish forestry sector. The afforestation grant and premium scheme administered by my department aims to increase the area under forest in Ireland from its current low base of just under 11%. In this context, it should be noted that the average is 38%, the EU average, that is, sorry. It is not intended or proposed that any increase in forest cover be undertaken without due regard to all other elements within the environments. The increase in the area under forest will be undertaken in a sustainable manner, contributing to the EU's priority of restoring, preserving and enhancing ecosystems related to, to agriculture and forestry. For this reason, all applications for approval to forest land are advertised on the Department's website and are subject to detailed consideration and consultation with a number of bodies, notice bodies, including the EPA, Antoshka and Inland Fisheries Ireland. It is useful to consider the context of forest cover and the level of afforestation in Leitrim against national figures. Forests currently account for about 10.8% of the land area of the country, with the forest cover in counties varying widely. In terms of forest cover's proportion of the total county land area, the second national forestry inventory found that County Wicklow, the Garden County, has the highest forest cover at 17.7%, and Leitrim closely followed, as the figure you have mentioned, about 16.7%. As regards the ownership of lands under forestry in County Leitrim, and I checked this figure out, I understand that the bulk of the new forest plantation over the last couple of years at least has been undertaken by farmers. For example, of the 513 hectares of new forest planting for which grants were paid in 2015, 81% were undertaken by farmers. And likewise, in 2014, of the 272 hectares of new forest in respect of which payments were made, just under 96% were done by farmers. It's also worth noting, and maybe we need to go on a little bit of an awareness exercise, that farmers who hold a valid herd number continue to have an advantage over non-farmers in that they can qualify for basic payment and forestry premiums on the same land. They also qualify for ANC and lost payments, whereas non-farmers cannot do so. Forestry is a viable land use alternative, and farmers who have availed of the afforestation in significant schemes over the last number of years. However, notwithstanding the continued availability of state-funded afforestation programme, national plantation figures have declined over the last number of years, with payments made in 2014 for the new planting of 6,156 hectares, compared with a peak of over 23,000 hectares in 1995. The general consensus is that it is necessary to achieve a higher rate of new forest planting in order to ensure a continuous secure supply of quality timber to the forest industry. It is therefore vital to address the decline in the planting level now and for the long-term future viability of the industry. The afforestation and grant premium scheme currently available under the Forestry Programme 2014 to 2020 offers a single premium rate. The scheme under former programmes offered different rates and for different periods of time depending on whether the applicant was a farmer or non-farmer. This was a change encouraged by the EU in terms of an equitable approach and also a recommendation from Coford. However, in addition to an increased supply of timber in the long term, the other benefits of an increased forest planting should not be overlooked, for example, employment creation opportunities at the establishment phase and also those associated with the ongoing management of forests, including thinning and eventual clearfall. And just in relation to County Leitrim, it's worth noting that Masonite Ireland, just located just outside Carrick-on-Shannon, is one of the largest ratepayers in the county. It employs a significant number of people and makes a very important contribution to the local economy, being totally based on forestry.
Thanks, Minister.
And just in conclusion, Kirlik, and I'll respond to the Deputy. While an increase in planting levels is welcome, I am conscious of the concerns of the people of Leitrim and the farmers of Leitrim. And I am prepared to go up at a time that suits everybody, and I will consult with all members here, colleagues, just to try and organise that. And I mean, I do believe
thanks, Minister.
There's an approach here that we can actually work this out. So okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. Deputy John O'Sullivan.